starring June Lockhart, Hugh Riley, John Provost as Timmy, and, of course, Lassie.
But there's still a lot of water running off the mountains. If that forest fire hadn't burned all the ground cover, there wouldn't be any danger.
That's what the ranger told us at school. Fire prevention isn't only to help save trees, it's to prevent floods.
Too bad those careless campers didn't think of that last summer.
Can the river go much higher, Mom?
Maybe. A couple of more inches and it could flood.
But Dad won't let it. Boy, everybody in the valley must be down there. I've never seen so many sandwiches.
Well, maybe the women's committee... Maybe the women's committee can't fill sandbags, but they certainly know what to do when it comes to filling empty stomachs.
I wish I could help, Mom. Can I?
But you are helping, dear.
I mean, why can't Lassie and I come along?
Because a small boy and a big dog would only be in the way. Besides, don't you have something important to do? Like homework?
Oh, no.
What's the matter?
I forgot to write down what the pages were.
Oh, Timmy.
It's okay, Mom. I'll get them from Flip. I'll telephone him.
Well, I guess that ought to be enough now.
Lassie, I'll help you take them out.
All right, put your jacket on then, dear.
Come here, Lassie. You can have this one.
Salt in mine. Old fudge doesn't taste good unless it's just got a little bit. I heard a click on the line, didn't you? This line's in use. Who's on here?
It's me, Timmy Martin. Now I'd like to use the phone, please. It's important.
Well, may I suggest, Timmy Martin, that polite little boys don't interrupt grown-ups. And if you have any manners at all, you know enough to wait until someone's finished talking.
Honest, Mrs. Harper, I won't be long. I've just got to ask Flip Rogers about my homework.
When I am through... Yes, Augusta? Well, if you think so.
But you know how thoughtless children will hold up a line for hours.
Well, very well, Mr. Timmy, you can have the line. But just remember that other people are entitled to use it, too.
Thank you, and I'll remember. I'll just be a few minutes.
Operator.
Hello, Ginny.
Oh, hi there, Timmy.
Would you ring me the Rogers, please?
There's no answer there, Timmy.
I've just got to get my homework assignment from him.
Why don't you try again in a few minutes? They may be out at the barn or someplace close by.
Okay, Ginny. Thank you and goodbye.
Thank you. Hi.
Oh, Paul. You look exhausted.
No more than the others.
Well, I brought a lot of sandwiches.
Good. The men are ready for them. Look, while you're serving them, I'll take the pickup and go back to the house and get some more sacks. There's still a lot of sandbagging to be done.
All right. Be careful, though, will you? And be sure to keep Timmy inside.
Right.
Dear Flip, please write down the homework pages and give them to Lassie. Thank you. Your friend, Timmy Martin.
To Flip, Lassie. Take me out to Flip, girl. Wait a minute. I got something that'll give you the idea.
Where's Lassie going?
Oh, I sent her to Flip's house with a message. I tried to telephone him to get my homework assignment, but then Mrs. Harper was using the telephone again. So I sent Lassie.
Now, with Lassie around, we don't even need a phone now, do we?
That's right. Where's Mom?
She's still down at the river.
I wish I could help, too.
Well, you can, Timmy. You know those burlap sacks that we use for potatoes?
Uh-huh.
Come on, you can help me haul them out of the barn and put them in the pickup. Okay. Well, thanks, Timmy. You're a big help.
Can I come along, Dad?
Well,
I can help you unload them, and I can hold the sack while you fill them up.
Well, what about Lassie? You wouldn't want her to come back here and find you weren't here, would you?
I forgot.
Your mother will be back soon. You know, if you and Lassie are here, why, she'd feel a lot better if this wind got any worse.
Okay, Dad. We'll take care of her.
It's a deal. No, Lassie. No, no, no. Stay where you are. Stay there. Lassie, sit. There. Now you stay right where you are. Listen, Lassie. Go get Timmy. Go get Timmy, Lassie. Go on. Good girl, Lassie.
Did you lose the note? Is that it? Okay, I'll come with you.
And do just what I tell you, understand?
Yes, Dad.
The wind snapped that tree and it fell across the truck. And these power lines came down. You see those sparks hitting the ground? Well, if you touch the pickup truck, it'd be the same as touching the end of that live wire. You wouldn't be able to let go. That current is so strong that you'd be paralyzed or else killed by the shock. Lassie's already had a shock, but luckily she was thrown clear.
But how will you get out?
Well, that's what you've got to help me do. You run back to the house, tell Jenny to call the power company, and have them shut the current off. I can't move in here until they do. If I so much as touch a piece of metal in this truck, I might be electrocuted. You understand?
Yes, Dad, I understand.
That I wouldn't tell it to a soul because it's about Barbara, and you
know what good friends they are.
Hello, Mrs. Harper.
Who's this?
It's me, Timmy Martin.
Would you please get off the line? This line's in use.
Well, Mrs. Harper, this is an emergency. Honest.
Oh, Timmy Martin, I know what you consider an emergency. If you don't get off this line right away, I'm going to speak to your parents about you.
That's just it. My dad was on the way to the river when a... No, it's not about to overflow. Not yet.
But you mean it was about to? Well, why wasn't I told sooner? I don't have a car. I'll have to get somebody to help me right away.
It's not about the flood, Mrs. Harper. It's my dad. He wants me to...
Well, good gracious. Have you any idea how much you worried me? Did you hear him, Pauline? Playing tricks like that just to try to get us off the telephone?
Mrs. Harper, won't you please just listen a minute?
Oh, my goodness, I think it's my pies burning up. And it's all that little boy's fault, too. I'll have to call you back.
Hello? Hello, Mrs. Harper? Hello?
Naughty little boy.
Mrs. Barnes. Oh, yes, I will let you know if there's any further news. I understand it's still rising. Well, Lassie. I didn't expect you here today. What was this? Dear Jenny, a wire is down, and it's an emergency. Please call me. I can't call you. Well, what's the trouble, Lassie? Is something wrong with Timmy? Looks like that Mrs. Harper is still talking. Well, that's funny. The line is dead. I'll bet that's what Timmy's message meant. One of our phone lines must be down. Hello? Oh, this is Jenny, Mrs. Hayden. I'm just checking the wires through the valley. I can't get through to the Martins. No, it's not flooding yet. Oh, will you hold on a minute? I have another call. Hello? Operator? Oh, yes, Mike.
Listen, Jenny, we got a lot of juice going out. I think this wind has snapped one of our lines. Anybody been complaining about losing their power?
Power line. That explains Timmy's message. I thought it was about one of our phone lines. Hold on a minute, Mike. I'll see if I can get you some information. That receiver must be off the hook.
Couldn't call me back.
Well, thank goodness I have a line. Now we'll find out what this is all about, won't we, Lassie? Didn't Timmy home, Lassie? Mike, are you still there?
Yeah, what's the pitch, Jenny?
Well, they don't answer. I guess they're not at home. Wait a minute. I have Lassie here. She'll know where they are. She can take you to them.
I'll be by in the truck and pick her up right away.
Timmy, what did Jenny say? How long will it take? Timmy, what happened?
I couldn't get her, Dad, but I tried.
You didn't tell Jenny what I told you?
I didn't even talk to her. Mrs. Harper was using the telephone again.
Well, didn't you explain that it was an emergency?
I tried to, but she wouldn't even listen to me. But I sent Lassie with a note to Jenny.
Good boy.
But what if something happens to Lassie? Then she doesn't get there.
Mr. Martin? Jenny thought Lassie'd find you. Mighty fine dog you got.
Hello, Al. We've located the brake. It's on the North Fork line. Cut it off fast. The line's down across the truck. The driver's okay, but don't waste any time.
Good job, son.
Thank you for saving Dad's life, Lassie. Good dog.
Well, I better get this tree off the truck.
I'll give you a hand.
Me too.
Can I have some more, please? Mmm, you sure may.
We prevented the water from flooding over, didn't we, Dad?
Yeah, we sure did. You know, unless it rains a cloudburst, I don't think we have anything else to worry about this year. Oh.
It's all right, I'll get it.
Oh, please, may I come in?
Oh, hello.
Mrs. Martin, Mr. Martin. Oh, and Timmy. Well, Jenny told me about what happened, and I just think it's awful that anybody's a phone hog. Will you forgive me, Timmy?
Sure. Mom said we all stay on the phone longer than we need to. I don't want to be a phone hog either.
That wouldn't be one of your famous pies, would it?
Oh, my goodness, however did you guess?
Oh, it's beautiful.
Yeah. There we are.